But I do want to bring in Brandon now to the conversation. Brandon obviously works very closely with Border Patrol. Brandon, from your perspective, how do you think the United States should handle this group of people attempting to cross the border?
Well, I think that we have to separate the two issues. If they come to the ports of entry, that is a legal process as long as they're not making a false claim to asylum. But we've already had, in the Border Patrol yesterday, we've already arrested more than 50 people from this caravan that crossed the border illegally. Now, that is, in fact, a criminal act, and it is something that we have to take them in custody for. We have to process them for. Then you also have to consider that if these people that are coming in and are making an asylum claim, it is expected that they're going to show up to their court date sometime later in the future. But 80% of those people that make an asylum claim, they never show up to their court date, which then also criminalizes the act and makes it a very serious problem for law enforcement agents.
But Brandon, from your perspective, how do you think the president's rhetoric throughout this conversation has impacted this conversation? Shouldn't the president just talk about this from a legal perspective? Let's bring these folks in. Yeah. We'll bring additional lawyers to the border to try and adjudicate these processes and figure out the people that deserve to be here and those that should go back to their home countries. Does it help at all that he's kind of notched the rhetoric up a bit?
Well, I mean, I have to look at the last comment that Secretary Nielsen made, and she was talking about illegal acts. She wasn't talking about legal acts. They are, in fact, sending more judges to the border. They are, in fact, sending more attorneys to the border. And again, we're going to handle this in two separate issues, the legal issue and the illegal issue, which is the part that I have to deal with, which is the illegal issue.
Right. All right, Raul, how about from your perspective? I mean, is this is the bigger problem the illegal element of this caravan, or is this more a humanitarian story that we're dealing with?
Well, to be honest, this situation has elements of both. But in my view, the Trump administration has mishandled this in two ways. First of all, as Maria pointed out, by characterizing this entire movement as some sort of attempt to storm the border and associating it with criminality, talking about all these alleged rapes, which did not happen on the way to the border, that has created this association in the public's mind that these people are trying to sneak into the country illegally, which they are not. They are here to lawfully claim asylum. And under the rules of asylum, people may enter the country without papers or illegally, technically, but they do have that legal right to ask for asylum. And that is their right under U.S. immigration law, under international law, even under the UN High Commission on Refugees. The problem with how the Trump administration is handling this now, they are now sending more immigration judges to the border, more Border Patrol agents. That's not what they need, because to process these people, it's basically a two-step process. First, they have to establish that they face credible fear of persecution at home, and then their asylum claim will be evaluated. What they need for that is asylum officers. Now, we have a great shortage of those, just as we have a shortage of immigration judges. In this entire country, think about the 11 million undocumented people and all the times we talk here about immigration. Our country only has about 350 immigration judges. When the Trump administration sends these judges to the border, that just increases the backlogs for legal immigrants and other undocumented people whose cases are working their way through the courts. So they have mishandled this, in my view, from start to finish. And again, these are legal processes that these people are attempting to do, and they have the right by under international law.
Well, I think, Raul, to a certain extent, what you're alluding to, which is kind of the big elephant in the room with this discussion, is that the country's immigration system is broken no matter what side of the issue you tend to be on. And the president actually did talk about that last night during his rally in Michigan. Listen to what the president had to say about the current immigration system.
Are you watching that mess that's going on right now with the caravan coming up? Are you watching this? And our laws are so weak, they're so pathetic. And let me tell you, we've gotten Mexico to work with us on stopping a lot of what's pouring in, but we have the worst laws anywhere in the world.
So, Maria, you can interpret what the president's saying here in many different respects, but it seems to me as though he's saying that these asylum rules are maybe a little too loose, and that the folks that do end up on this border, he's implying that he would like to see fewer of them come in than more.
I actually think if he had said that, then that would make more sense than the way that he is putting it. I don't think he's put any thought into this at all, other than to frame this in the terms for his base, which the way that he talks about it at these rallies and the way that he has referred to these migrants in the caravan, that's nothing but political crack for his base, Ryan. Mm-hmm. And he does that repeatedly when he's in political trouble. Going into the midterms, he's in political trouble. The problem with that is there's no question that our immigration laws are broken, that our immigration system is broken. We, as you know, have been trying to deal with this for years and years and years. There was a terrific opportunity in 2013 to pass a comprehensive immigration law that could have fixed a lot of this. It was even passed by the famous Gang of Eight, including Republican senators. It went to the House of Representatives back then, who set it up by John Boehner, who famously told Barack Obama that he was not gonna bring it to a vote in the House of Representatives because he could not have a law that would pass with majority Democratic support and minority Republican support. This puts it square in the lap of Republicans for the reason why immigration laws are not fixed today. And Donald Trump is taking advantage of that in a way that, to me, is contrary to every American civic principle and the way that this country was founded.
Okay, all right, Maria
Ryan, if I can jump in, I just want to mention that this is very much contrary to our rule of law, because our Congress, when they established the rules governing the number of people admitted each year for asylum, unlike virtually every other category under immigration law, there are no limits on the number of people who are admitted for asylum from year to year, and that's because people who apply for asylum are fleeing desperate situations. This is not what Trump calls a mess. This is a humanitarian crisis, and these people, many of them children, are coming from some of the most dangerous countries in the
that's
world.
Right.